Hello everyone, my name is Antonio Oliveira and today we are going to talk about the novel Open Foam Solver for Aluminium Alloy Profile Extrusion. This work was undertaken in the framework of my master thesis in cooperation with Portalum, an aluminium profile extrusion company. First, let's start with a brief introduction where we are going to talk about the aluminium alloy extrusion industry, its applications and challenges, and then the motivations and goals for this work. In state of the art, the constitutive equations and boundary conditions will be discussed, as well as studies carried out in the literature and the commercial aluminium alloy extrusion software is available in the industry. Then, alleged foam implementation and verification is the topic to come, where the solver, the constitutive model and the boundary conditions are implemented. Thereafter, in the following topic, the entire code is assessed in representative case of aluminium alloys extrusion. Finally, some conclusions and suggestions for future work are given. The industry that most uses aluminium alloy profiles is the construction and transportation industry, due to properties like low density, good electrical and thermal conductivity, reflectivity and low toxicity. Here we can see some examples of aluminium extrusion profiles like heat sinks, door handles, window structures. There are different types of extrusion process like direct extrusion, indirect, hydrostatic, side, impacts, and much more. We will focus on direct extrusion because it's the method that the company which motivated this work uses and is the most common in all world. Here there is a video of the direct extrusion process. Here we are watching the dies which are inserted into the press. Then the material is preheated and also placed into the press, and then there is a ram that forces the material through the die and the profile exit. The extrusion dies are the most important component in all extrusion process because they have the function to assure that material flows through the die outlet with the same average velocity. In this image, we can see the flowing material, the mandrel, which makes the inner contour of the profile, and the die, which makes the outer contour. Inside of the extrusion die, through the cross-section cut view, we can see the portholes and welding chamber, where the independent flow fronts merge and form the weld lines. The material passes through the bearing length in red, and then the profile is extruded. The bearing length is one important region in the extrusion die. It is the parallel zone located at the die exits. It will settle the shape of the extruded profile. The longer the bearing length, the higher the resistance to the flow, and aims promoting a balanced flow distribution by changing its length in different regions, since it allows to adjust the local restriction to the flow and then control the flow distribution. Here, we can see a closer look of the bearing in the mandrel and die components. The dies before going into production have to be checked. This is done through experimental trial and error iterations where the billet is extruded and the balance of the flow at the exit is verified. If the design is not satisfactory, the bearing length is corrected until the dimensions are correct. It is a time-consuming process and also expensive because each test can cost 400 euros and each die can be subjected to several tests before going into production. It is in this context that computational modeling can be relevant with the aiming of optimized bearing length with background process simulation, reducing the resources spent in physical tests. In this image, it is an example where it is possible to see the extrusion of heat sink, in which the upper part of the fins has higher relative velocity than the lower part, which promotes a non-uniform flow. The profile simulation study, shown in the right image, could have been carried before the die went into production, correcting the bearing length so the flow was uniform. Portalum is an aluminium alloy casting and extrusion company located in Faf, Portugal, and was the company that motivated this work. They are divided into divisions, the casting division with a capacity of production of 40 tons of aluminium alloy per day and extrusion division with a capacity of 15 tons per day. The motivation for this work is to increase the knowledge of aluminium extrusion, improve the design methodology, and reduce production costs without affecting the product performance. And the goals are to create a computational code capable of simulating the extrusion process of aluminum alloys, the all-aged foam, verify and validate developed codes, and test the application of the code in an industrial relevant problem. Now, in the state of the art, consider equations for aluminum alloys. Defective flow stress is a function of temperature and defective strain rate. By checking the graph, it can be seen that the increase in strain rate increases defective flow stress. However, an increase in temperature reduces defective flow stress. These relations are made through mechanical characterization tests of aluminum alloys. However, they will not be discussed during this presentation. There are some constitutive models present in the literature that intend to describe the aluminum alloy's dependence on temperature and effective strain rates. They are the Nortonoff, the Ansel Spittal, and Zener-Ullmann. The model that will be used during this work is Zener-Ullmann because it is the method that best describes aluminum alloys at high temperatures and is the most used method in the literature. During extrusion process, tribological condition of the tools and flow material interface are important on the shape of the extruded material, and a reliable and accurate model is mandatory. There are some models in the literature that correlate friction stress and normal contact pressure. One of them is the Coulomb friction model, where with the increase in the normal contact pressure, the friction stress increases. The shear friction is another model which shows a constant behavior in the friction stress for different values of normal contact pressure, and also Levanov model, which is a generalization of the Coulomb model and shear friction model. The model used in this work is the shear friction because it presents good results in the description of the contact of the flow material and the tools. There are already some studies in the aluminum alloy extrusion fields. Here we can see one of those studies where it is performed the simulation of the extrusion profile shown in the picture. The die, the mandrel, and the CAD model are also illustrated. The material for this study is the AA6063, where the Zener-Ullmann constitutive model was selected, and also the shear friction and Coulomb friction models for the wall boundary condition. Simulation fields of stress, strain rate, temperature, and velocity solutions are shown in this picture, and they are very important for selecting process parameters. But the most important field is the velocity distribution at the outlet, and as we can see, the flow is not uniform since the average velocity at the outlet is different. From the new picture, it can be concluded that the code was able to correctly describe the profile extrusion process, as it experimentally obtained the same results. There are some commercial extrusion process softwares available in the industry, such as Keyform or Altair Inspired Extrude Metal, that perform this type of study. They have also included some features that can be used to improve the extrusion process, like the nose cone prediction, transverse weld length, weld quality, skin tracking, and much more. So, all-aged foam implementation and verification. We start with solver implementation. We know that the extrusion process is an incompressible, non-Newtonian, non-isothermal, and steady state. We start with a simple foam, which already solves the linear momentum conservation law and continuity equation. And we add the energy conservation equation. Here is a script where the first term is the advection term, second term is the fusion term, and third term is the source term or the viscous dissipation. Then we proceed to the Zener-Ullmann implementation, where first we add the temperature from the solver, putting a maximum and minimum limiting variable in order to limit the solution between common values. Then we calculate strain rate, effective strain rate, which must be higher also than a minimum value that will already be explained, the Zener-Ullmann, defective flow stress, and the kinematic viscosity. As we can see, in the kinematic viscosity, defective strain rate is in the denominator, and for that reason, can never be zero. And that's why we have defective strain rate limiting value. To verify the constitutive model implementation, the flow between parallel plates study was performed, where it was prescribed an inlet velocity common to extrusion process. Simulation was performed with three different refinement levels, M15, M30 and M60, with 15, 30 and 60 cells in Y direction. The results were compared with an analytical solution as shown in the graph. The results are in good agreement with analytical solutions since the root mean square error for the coarser mesh was 2% and 0.6 and 0.3 for M30 and M60. Constitutive equation implementation was verified, so we proceed to wall boundary condition implementation. As previously stated, the slip boundary condition implementation was performed using the shear friction law. The shear friction law is calculated by multiplying the friction coefficient, M, with the von Mises shear yield stress, K. In order to develop the boundary condition, velocity at the boundary was defined, being dependent on a strain rate function. If the strain rate function is 1 or higher, velocity at the boundary is 0. But if it is lower than 1, it is equal to the velocity of the nearest cell, UPT, multiplied by 1 minus the strain rate function. The name given to the boundary condition was shear friction model foam, and first, the viscosity at the boundary is assessed from the constitutive equation. Then, the von Mises shear yield stress at the boundary is calculated based on the effective flow stress. After, it is assessed the distance from the boundary to the cell to the centrum of the nearest cell, and the magnitude of the velocity of the nearest cell is calculated. The strain function is calculated by adding the friction coefficient in the equation, and finally, the velocity at the boundary is calculated. To verify the slip boundary condition implementation, the quad flow was performed, where there is a moving and a static wall, where the slip boundary condition was prescribed with different friction coefficients. Also, it was used at a constant value for effective strain rates, and the analytical solution is shown under the graph. In the chart, it can be seen that numerical solution is in agreement with analytical one. For a friction coefficient of 0, there is full sliding, and with the increase of the friction coefficient, there is a decrease of the velocity in the wall. For a friction condition of 1, there is full sticking, as expected. In order to reinforce the study of the implementation of the boundary condition, a study of the plane strain for the extrusion through a convergent die was performed with the goal to verify the shear friction model foam comparing with the Segal experimental case and basic numerical simulation using a constant yield stress instead of the Zener-Ullmann constitutive equation, and it was used a friction coefficient of 1 in the convergent wall and slip boundary condition in the first and in the third wall. The solutions for Segal experiments, basic numerical simulation, and Alleged foam are shown in this figure for velocity parallel to the flow direction. When comparing Alleged foam with experimental case, it can be noticed some similarities in the velocity distribution close to the wall, as there is a zone of lower velocity at the beginning of the convergent wall, and thereafter an increase in velocity. On the other hand, Basic's case study demonstrates a constant low velocity through the wall, possibly motivated by a different boundary condition applied. All the cases have similar flow lines distribution in the channel. The solutions of the velocity perpendicular to the flow direction show the cases are in good agreement. From the Coet flow and convergent die study, we can conclude that the boundary condition implementation is verified, since the analytical, numerical, and experimental solutions are in good agreement. Now, Alleged foam verification and validation. We will start with the U-shaped extrusion profile, in which the goal is to compare Alleged foam with Inspire Extrude Metal software. In both cases, constitutive model of Zener-Ullmann was used. However, as a student license was used, the Inspire Extrude Metal software does not allow the selection of friction models. In this way, several simulations were carried out with different friction coefficients in order to identify which solutions are closest. Velocity was checked in 22 central points in the outlet between A and E, equally spread across the profile, as shown in the picture. Also, symmetry boundary condition was used in simulations. In this graph, it can be seen the velocity distribution at the outlet points between A and D for expired extrude metal and alleged foam. The velocity increased between A and D, as posed, However, solutions vary in velocity distribution between D and E. In simulation of aleshed foam, there is a decrease in velocity, as it should happen because it cannot be higher at the border, but this happens at inspired extruded metal solutions. Still, there is a good correlation between aleshed foam and inspired extruded metal solutions. Now, we will see the simulation fields. Here, we are watching the velocity field, which was previously discussed, with higher magnitude at the outlet, as expected. Also, temperature fields are very similar. Temperature has a greater magnitude at the outlet, due to viscous dissipation, and consequently lower at the extremities, due to less viscous dissipation and higher heat transfer. Defective flow stress field is also in agreement with the solutions of inspired extruded metal, with minimum value of 3 MPa at the ends and 42 MPa at the bearing, where the shear stress is the higher. For the same reason, strain rate field is higher at the edges of the bearing, and is also constant with inspired extruded metal solutions. Finally, the pressure field has the most significant differences. As expected, the pressure decreases from the inlet to the outlet. However, the magnitude of the solutions is different. This may be due, possibly, to the use of different boundary conditions that directly influence this field. Finally, the multi-hole extrusion profile. This last study aims to validate the aleshed foam with the industrial relevant extrusion geometry, and to verify if the velocity distribution is consistent with the dimensions assigned by the designer in the bearing zone. In this image, we can see the different bearing lengths assigned by the designer in order to have a balanced flow at the outlet. It is possible to see in this new figure the die layout with four cavities in order to increase the production. Through the technical drawing, it was possible to design the die-cad model and the flow material. We are using constant bearing length in order to highlight the velocity distribution at the outlet. The figures show the extrusion die that Portalum used to extrude the profile. Symmetry condition was used to simplify the case study, and the mesh was performed with CF mesh. The model has an overall 400,000 cells with a greater refinement level in the outlets and bearing due to higher gradients. The total simulation time was 2 hours and 30 minutes, which represents an efficient simulation time. Focusing now on the velocity field distribution, we will only address the lower cavity, as the fields show similar results. It is possible to observe high variation in the average velocity in the outlet, as expected, since we are using constant bearing length, with 65 and 92 millimeters per second at the ends and 153 millimeters per second in the center region. In order to better assess the velocity profile distribution with dimensions assigned by the designer, the bearing length was overlapped to the velocity profile distribution at the exit. The profile was divided into different regions, the most restrictive, where there is a greater friction effect due to bearing walls, and the less restrictive areas, where the material flows more easily. Starting with zone A, the most restrictive zone, which is at the ends of the profile and where the length of the bearing is shorter to facilitate the flow. Then we have the zones B, C, D, and E, where the velocity gradually increases and consequently the length of the bearing. Finally, we have zone F, the less restrictive area to the flow, which corresponds to the zone where the length of the bearing is greater to delay the material. It can be concluded that bearing length rules are being respected, since bearing is longer for thicker sections and towards the center of the die, and bearing is shorter for high restriction areas. So, it can be concluded that aleshed foam is a tool capable of simulating the extrusion of aluminum alloys. The parallel plates, coet, and convergent die flow cases allow to verify the implementation of constitutive and wall boundary conditions. Solution errors are very low compared with analytical, experimental, and numerical solutions, as we have seen. Aleshed foam provides solutions similar to an inspired extrude model, and has proven to be able to evaluate the extrusion die design typical of the industry. Also, 2 hours and 30 minutes is an efficient simulation time that can be easily introduced in the production process. Portalum Company can use now Alice Foam to improve the understanding about the influence of the process parameters, like temperature and velocity, on the extrusion process. Also, it's able to reduce the costs related to die design and extrusion process parameters. Some suggestions for future work is the bearing length automatic optimization. The developed code can verify the velocity distribution at the outlet, allowing to qualitatively evaluate the design of the die. However, the next step should be the automatic optimization of the bearing length so that the flow at the outlet is uniform, assisting the designer in the die sizing. Then, the Levanov friction model. Although shear friction models show the good performance at slip under condition, it overestimates the friction stress for lower normal contact stress. Levanov is an accurate model for lower and higher normal contact stress. Automatic mesh generation algorithm for different mesh refinement levels. As all extrusion cases are similar and have similar patches, it is possible to create different refinement scripts, for example in CF mesh, in order to reduce pre-processing time of the case studies. Also, code optimization can be performed in order to decrease the calculation time, and lastly, improve solver to be able to cope unsteady problems, like skin tracking and weld location and quality, which are features that commercial softwares already provide. This was my work. Thanks for your attention. Goodbye.